الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم ربنا تقبل طاعتنا يا كريم، اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب يا كريم يا رحمن يا رحيم، اجعلنا من عتقائك من النيران يا رب العالمين. اللهم واشف مرضانا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا يا كريم يا رحمن يا رحيم. And the daughter of our brother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower her with his mercy and give her complete shifa, as all our brother who are suffering or our sister from any illness. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illa hu, alimul ghaybi wa shahada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, arhamur rahim. Just a reminder for all of us of the gift and the favor before we're starting of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the only God subhanahu wa ta'ala, creator. There is no one who can associate with him. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, say Alhamdulillah. That Allah does not have a son, Alhamdulillah. That Allah does not have a partner, Alhamdulillah. That Allah does not have anyone who influence him or have a pressure on him, say Alhamdulillah. And glorify him, Allahu Akbar. وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِّنَ الذُّلِّ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. Just, you know, among the people who mashallah work in the interfaith, you can see in the social media spread all over the Muslim as these people, you know, they alhamdulillah, they are nice people and everything, but when they share their creed, it's really for the believer to be aware and to be also have his heart to not be desensitized to such messages. So one of the messages that been spread all over, and you know, because I know where this, who's will be seeing this message. So they said, you know, hear the great sermon about, you know, the last word of Jesus before he died on the cross. This word changed the whole world. فنقول سبحان الله عما يقولون علوا كبيرا. And the Muslim, when he said the way that he's being presented, someone will say, oh, what were the last words? But you have to be aware, they were not the last words, because Isa was never being crucified. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال وما صلبوه وما قتلوه ولكن شبه لكم. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا. So three times in the same ayah, Surah An-Nisa, they didn't kill him, they didn't crucify him, certainly they didn't kill him. فَنَحْنَا, for us as a believer, alhamdulillah, in the society, always to remind ourselves and talk to our children about the true creed of Islam and the greatness of Isa alayhi salam as the messenger of Islam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have a whole surah in the Quran in the name of his mother Maryam alayhi salam that we just have recited during this first part of the Taraweeh, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the Siddiqa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the blessing on her alayhi salam and on her son alayhi salam. They were, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they used to eat food. It's amazing. Under kayfa nubayyinu lahum al-ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they used to eat food. See how we make details in detail the ayat for them. When you think of it, what is the evidence of eating food? That they are not as they claim. Eating food, it means subhanAllah, it comes subject to vulnerability, subject to need, subject to striving to survive, subject to weakness, sleeping, and subhanAllah, all the things that subhanAllah surrounding the human being from weakness is in Isa alayhi salam. Therefore, how can he be as they claim? But let's, you know, reflect on one of the ayat, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Kahf, قال, وَلَقَدْ in the ayah, وَعُرُضُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ صَفًّا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَ كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. قال وعرض على ربك صفا ولم نغادر منهم احدا. He wants you to reflect on this ayah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he said how they are claiming that Isa alayhi salam is the son of God, or what they saying is God, he said something like, you really have to understand it and you have to feel it, not to understand it. He said almost the whole heavens, تَكَادُ السَّمَوَاتُ, is going to scatter, and the earth to split, and the mountains, subhanAllah, to be destroyed, turn into dust, because to call that God has a son. You have to understand that. Which is mean, تَكَادُ, almost, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is holding them, because if the heaven and the earth and the mountain, they had the free will as you do, then none of us will be still surviving on this earth. Because they're going to react. They're going to prohibit what is wrong. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ تَكَادُ, for you to understand, everyone is going to come a servant, abd to Allah. Everyone. Everyone. Including the nobles, the best ever people worked on earth, who are the messenger of Allah, they're gonna come in the day of judgment, abdan. كلهم آتيه يوم القيامة عبدا. فعرضوا على ربك صفا قال فلم نغادر منهم أحدا. This is very important. We didn't miss anyone. I want you to reflect. When you read this ayah, every time we have that, subhanAllah, that inclination when we read something is like we are not part of it. The punishment is happening outside. Hellfire, I am far from it. But this one, you cannot escape it, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're not going to miss anyone, including you. Including you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. So you're going to be there, with no doubt. With this ayah, you're going to see yourself on the land of resurrection. Qala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ, because as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has given us the description of the land of resurrection, which is this earth is going to be changed. Wallahu a'lam, this is another dimension of the Ansir. But qala, أَرْضٌ بَيْضَاءٌ مَلْسَاءٌ, is like a flat. You don't see anything. So nobody can hide. You cannot hide under, you know, behind the building. There is no building. Or behind the rock. There is no rock. All the mountains, subhanAllah, they turn into dust. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا. It's going to be flattened to the earth. You cannot, subhanAllah, hide. And then when your book comes, قَالَ وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ. They're so scared what is in this book. And then as soon as they open, they find everything. So the most shocking thing, they're going to see the most infinite details that they will never have thought that they're going to be in this record. So imagine, like you're seeing your brother, he didn't see you, and you grab him from the back. I mean, out of love that you have your brother. But he might not have been in that situation to be, you know, grabbed like that. Maybe he had some frowning in the face. And then you realize what you have done is not good. That is going to be in your record. That is going to be in your record. Then, and then one of the, in the hadith that has been, you know, kind of, you want to depict how going to be your record. Your record, if you try to make a picture, you know, a drawing, is going to be like, you know, shelves, and the shelves, in every shelf there's cases. And this, or cabbies. And this cabbage is either dark or light. These are the hours of every part of your life, the hours of your life. This hour has salat, is going to be light. This hour have negligence, is not going to have light. This hour have sin, don't even talk about it. Then subhanAllah, as one said, the best book ever that you are compiling and writing is your record. So when you go to see it, you don't want to be like those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mentioned in his book, this mujrimeen, there will be, subhanAllah, there will be wowing, there will be screaming, there will be regretting, there will be biting on their hands. You're not going to be one of them, inshaAllah ta'ala, as you are witnessing in Ramadan, and sincerely asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save you, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us. What is the most important thing that we need truly to have in our provision, in our background, in our luggage that we are traveling with in this dunya? We have said it many times, but from this ayat that we are studying or reciting, there is something, subhanAllah, is your trust into the wisdom of Allah. When you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reliance, it has an understanding. In Islam, God does not work in a mysterious way. No, He is the all-wise. He's not mysterious. He's not something like random. He's not something that is now happened or is mysterious. No, it's wisdom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-wise. Then when you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you rely He is the all-wise, you know whatever happened to you in your life is going in one direction. It's going to direction of your success. Whatever it happened to you, you will not be able to comprehend His wisdom subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we are limited. We are restricted in mind, in thinking, in life, in time, in space, and name it. We are limited from all, subhanAllah, the sides. So how can someone comprehend or argue with the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قال الله سبحانه خلق الإنسان من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين. Just look at our creation. We are blood clot. You know, a drop of semen, and to turn into a person big and wise, and you want to argue there's no God. There is no God. And the most shocking thing, this God, He's inviting you to forgive you and to shower you with His mercy. And you say, no, you do not exist. It's like someone very starving and someone generous, like, in Maghreb, he said, there's iftar. And someone said, no, there's no iftar. Yeah, he came, there's, are you not starving? Yeah, just walk the door, you're going to see it. And he said, no, there's no iftar. And you put a table and he's arguing, there's no iftar, that does not exist. This is exactly what these people, you see it like awkward, but this is how these people are, subhanAllah, behaving. But as we said, it required that key for the heart. One story, a very small story from the journey of Musa with Al-Khidr. And you see how amazing, subhanAllah, in the journey of the two orphans, not take one by one, but just for our reflection to see the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His knowledge and His rahmah. So the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in His mashia, that is going to take you to His mercy. You have to understand. So what you are enduring as difficulties is within Allah's wisdom, things that you do not know. But as long as you're holding fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then be certain that Allah has taken you into the shore of savior, of grace, of His grace, and to the shore of felicity, and to the shore of His rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Khidr, when he came to this town, people are, subhanAllah, the most greedy people ever. I mean, subhanAllah, they didn't ask them for money. قَالَ حَتَّى يَأَتَيَ أَهْلَ قَرْيَةٍ اسْتَطْعَمَا. We need food, some food. No. There is no house in this town that they actually, subhanAllah, were willing to give some food to Musa and to Al-Khidr. No one. That's why Musa, he could not stand it. When he saw this wall, Al-Khidr, he left everything and he started to rebuild it. Then you know what is the wisdom. But look, subhanAllah, the ayat of the Quran. قَالَ فَوَجَدَ فِيهَا جِدَارًا يُرِيدُ أَيَّنْ قَضْ. يُرِيدُ. It's like يُرِيدُ, this verb, is attribute to the wall. So the wall is about to collapse. The wall want to collapse. Say, this is the wall want to collapse. But the wall is holding itself. He's like waiting for the Khidr. يريد أن ينقذ. Allah has mercy for these two orphans in this very greedy nation, and the world is waiting for the khidr, waiting for the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يريد أن ينقذ فأقامه. It's like subhanAllah about to collapse. So Al-Khidr is like he appointed, he wanted directly in this town, not just traveling for no reason or no goal, he's going for this wall before his collapse. It's like the wall is, Ya Allah, I'm about to collapse. I cannot hold myself. And the Khidr came and he built it. So when he told them, subhanAllah, that under it is a treasure, belongs to two orphans, and their father was a righteous man. See the hikmah, the wisdom of Allah. Musa alayhi salam, how can he be patient for such a thing? He cannot, because he does not have knowledge. It's normal. No one, if Musa could not be patient for all the trial that he want or the test he want with the Khidr, no one of us. No one. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclosed to you his wisdom for the boy and that one killed, and for the safina, for the boat, and then for this one. And you see, subhanAllah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is caring about you and you do not know. He's watching over you and you do not know. Imagine, subhanAllah, a father died long ago, and these young kids, Allah want them to get to their strength. So then they're going to realize that they're thin. Allah sent Al-Khidr, a righteous man, and one of the greatest messenger of Allah to serve these two orphans. That's the kindness of Allah. That's the mercy of Allah. When Musa alayhi salam, he said, Ya Allah, expand my breast. Ya Allah, give me this and this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have been given that. And you said, we have been actually taking care of you. You ask me dua now. Look, since your mother, how she throw you into the crater. And she throw it into the river, the Yam. And the river was assigned to take Musa alayhi salam to the shore of Fir'aun. أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَى مَا يُحَىٰ أَنَقْضِ فِيهِ فِي التَّابُوتِ فَقْدِ فِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ الْيَمُّ, he is who's taking the charge. الْيَمُّ, he is the subject here. الْفَاعِلُ يُنْقِذُ, he is the one who's taken. Now the river, he said, I'm going to take, you know, when Musa, you know, imagine the river as a person. Musa said, now I'll take care of it. Don't worry, mother of Musa, I'm going to take it. So the river, take it, and where he put it? He put it in the shore. I'm going to take him, one of the worst enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we get you back to your mom. And you killed a person and we saved you. And we have you 10 years in Madian to reflect, to form yourself. وَجِئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ, and here you are here, Ya Musa, exactly at the appointed term. This is your life, brothers and sisters. When you ask dua, look how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you rahmah. Don't complain. You have been in the rahmah of Allah since you were a baby. And when you look at your parents, when they've been caring of you, that's the rahmah of Allah. That's why, subhanAllah, you have to care about them. You have to love them. You have to be honoring them. It's rahmah. And being here today is like Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, وَجِئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدْرٍ, and you came at the right moment, because you were in to be in any other place except in this place tonight, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped you and guided you based on your dua, based on your sincerity, based on many aspects in your life. So take advantage of this moment for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all, inshaAllah. فَاللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لَنَا أَجْمَعِينَ يَا رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَإِلَى الصَّلَاةِ يَرْحَمُكُمُ اللَّهُ.